When you or someone you know has been seriously
These are
injured.
Songs for General Hospital. General Hospital songs. General Hospital TV. This is Paul Beckman, Paul Rambo song. The caption here says, New, 2009. Jason tells Johnny what really happened to Claudia. Olivia seethes when she sees Sonny flirting with Lisa. Lulu anticipates her first real date with Dominic. General Hospital will be starting in a moment or so. I think in the meantime I'll tune my guitar.
Sawyer at ABC News headquarters in New York, and we're interrupting your regular programming because President Obama is about to make his first public statement after the attempted terrorist attack on Northwest Flight 253 on Christmas Day. The president is on vacation in Hawaii. He has been briefed by his national security team, and at this moment, the suspect, a 23-year-old Nigerian man, is being held at a federal prison in Michigan after officials say he tried to ignite explosives hidden in his underwear as the plane came in for a landing in Detroit. President Obama is speaking today from the Marine Corps base in Kaneohe, Hawaii, and we'll hear from him in seconds. But Brian Ross is here, chief investigative correspondent. We have word just in about who may be his sponsors, the terrorist sponsors.
Al-Qaeda of the Arabian Peninsula, Al-Qaeda in the Saudi neighbor Yemen, essentially said they took credit for the attack, praised what they called the hero, Abu Mutalib, and said he was able to penetrate all the equipment and newest techniques and rub the CIA's nose in.
Let's go now to the president.
We're taking to ensure the safety and security of the country. The investigation is ongoing, and I spoke again this morning with Attorney General Eric Holder, the Secretary of Homeland Security Janet Napolitano, and my counterterrorism and Homeland Security Advisor John Brennan. I asked them to keep continue monitoring the situation, to keep the American people and members of Congress informed. Now, here's what we know so far. On Christmas Day, Northwest Airlines Flight 253 was en route from Amsterdam, Netherlands, to Detroit. As the plane made its final approach to Detroit Metropolitan Airport, a passenger allegedly tried to ignite an explosive device on his body, setting off a fire. Thanks to the quick and heroic actions of passengers and crew, the suspect was immediately subdued, the fire was put out, and the plane landed safely. The suspect is now in custody and has been charged with attempting to destroy an aircraft. And a full investigation has been launched into this attempted act of terrorism, and we will not rest until we find all who were involved and hold them accountable. Now, this was a serious reminder of the dangers that we face and the nature of those who threaten our homeland. Had the suspect succeeded in bringing down that plane, it could have killed nearly 300 passengers and crew, innocent civilians preparing to celebrate the holidays with their families and friends. The American people should be assured that we are doing everything in our power to keep you and your family safe and secure during this busy holiday season. Since I was first notified of this incident, I've ordered the following actions to be taken to protect the American people and to secure air travel. First, I directed that we take immediate steps to ensure the safety of the traveling public. We made sure that all flights still in the air were secure and could land safely. We immediately enhanced screening and security procedures for all flights, domestic and international. We added federal air marshals to flights entering and leaving the United States. And we're working closely
making
in this country, federal, state, and local law enforcement
now,
with our international partners.
Making the sky
second,
safe.
I've ordered two important reviews because it's absolutely critical
making
that we learn
the
from this incident and take
safe
the necessary measures
making
to prevent future acts of terrorism.
Safe.
The first review involves our watch list system, which our government has
stop
had in place for many years
stop
to identify known and suspected terrorists so that we can prevent their entry into the United States.
Stop.
Apparently, the suspect
stop
in the Christmas incident was in this system, but not
terrorism
on a watch list such as the so-called no-fly list. So I've ordered a third review, not only of how information related
instead
to the subject was handled,
destroy,
but of the overall watch list system and how it can be strengthened. The second review will examine all screening policies, technologies, and procedures related to air travel. We need to determine just how the suspect was able to bring dangerous explosives aboard an aircraft and what additional steps we can take to thwart future attacks. Third, I've directed my national security team to keep up the pressure on those who would attack our country. We do not yet have all the answers about this latest attempt, but those who would slaughter innocent men, women, and children must know that the United States will do more than simply strengthen our defenses. We will continue to use every element of our national power to disrupt, to dismantle, and defeat the violent extremists who threaten us, whether they are from Afghanistan or Pakistan, Yemen or Somalia, or anywhere where they are plotting attacks against the U.S. homeland. Finally, the American people should remain vigilant, but also be confident. Those plotting against us seek not only to undermine our security, but also the open society and the values that we cherish as Americans. This incident, like several that have preceded it, demonstrates that an alert and courageous citizenry are far more resilient than an isolated extremist. As a nation, we will do everything in our power to protect our country. As Americans, we will never give in to fear or division. We will be guided by our hopes, our unity, and our deeply held
we're
values.
Gonna do it now.
That's who we are,
making the
as Americans.
Safe.
That's what our brave men
against
and women in uniform are standing up for as they spend the holidays in harm's way.
We're making the
and
country
we will continue
safe
to do everything that we can to
again
keep America safe in the new year and beyond.
Oh, yeah.
Before I leave, let me also briefly address
good
the events that have taken place over
President
the last few days in the Islamic
Obama
Republic of Iran. The United States joins with the international community
good
in strongly condemning
President
the violent and unjust suppression
Obama
of innocent Iranian citizens, which has apparently resulted in detentions, injuries, and even death. For months, the Iranian people
God
saw nothing more
people
than exercise their universal rights. Each time they have done so, they have been met with the iron fist of brutality, even on solemn occasions and holy days. And each time that has happened, the world has watched with deep admiration for the courage and conviction of the Iranian people, who are part of Iran's great and enduring civilization. What's taking place within Iran is not about the United States or any other country. It's about the Iranian people and their aspirations for justice and better life for themselves. And the decision of Iran's leaders to govern through fear and tyranny will not succeed in making those aspirations go away. As I said in Oslo, it's telling when governments fear the aspirations of their own people more than the power of any other nation. Along with all three nations, the United States stands with those who seek their universal rights. We call upon the Iranian government to abide by the international obligations that it has to respect the rights of its own people. We call for the immediate release of all who have been unjustly detained within Iran. We will continue to bear witness to the extraordinary events that are taking place there, and I'm confident that history will be on the side of those who seek justice. Thank you very much, everybody, and Happy New Year.
And again, the president coming off vacation, Kaneohe, Hawaii, the Marine base there,
so,
to speak about not only the terrorist on board that plane, but
General
also
Hospital
what happened
songs
in Iran recently.
General Hospital should be resuming
Chief Investigative
after this.
First Responder Brian Ross. Among things he cited that have been done immediately, additional air marshals. Air marshal on board
well, it depends
the plane,
how long they talk.
Plane?
No air marshal on that Northwest flight. There were other air marshals. Some I've talked to
YouTube
say they
video can only be 10 minutes long
from Chicago to Boise, Idaho, and wondered why they weren't
on the international flights, but there were none on that flight.
Stopping this video.
Going to step up the pressure, including on Yemen, which you mentioned before, to disrupt the extremists. What does that
very
mean?
Soon.
To disrupt and defeat,
sorry about that. That's
particularly
good.
Al-Qaeda in Yemen, which has become the new staging area for Al-Qaeda
Tourette
attacks on the U.S. And they released a statement just before the president
I don't
spoke,
make those sounds
taking credit for the attack, calling Abdul-Muttalib their hero, and boasting his ability to go against American legendary intelligence and the latest and most expensive security techniques, as they say, rubbing their nose in it.
And let's turn now to White House correspondent Jake Tapper. Jake, a very different tone from the president than we heard initially from Homeland Security Secretary Janet Napolitano in the last 48 hours.
Well,